Hi, I'm Alejandro Hoyos, and today we're here at CES 2025 in Las Vegas, Nevada. And right now we are the HP room. And today with us we have Kevin. Hey, Kevin, how's it going?
Going well. Going
well. Nice to meet you. So I see you have here the latest Omen laptop, and it looks amazing. Can you tell us a little bit more about it?
Exactly. Are you a gamer?
Yes, I'm a gamer.
So what are you most concerned about when you're gaming?
Everything. Well, especially winning the game.
Yeah, winning the game. And to win the game, you absolutely need performance. So this one is our brand new Omen Max 16. And this is the best performance Omen laptop HP's ever made. It's got the latest brand new HX series Intel processors, Intel Ultra processors. It's got the latest NVIDIA 50 series graphics and fantastic 16-inch display up to 240 hertz refresh rate. And some cool things about it, like the backlit keyboard. It's a frameless keyboard, so the lighting shows up around the keys as well as through the keys, and you get a much, much more interesting lighting effect. It also has another light across the front that'll shine down on the desk in front of you, just to give you that ambiance that says, I'm gonna win this game. Nice. Some other things about it. Internally, it's got a built-in receiver, so there are several HyperX devices where when you turn the HyperX device on by the laptop, it'll detect it automatically and connect it. No dongle to lose or anything like that. Of course, it's got a 5-megapixel camera, so you can broadcast right from that camera. And one of the biggest issues on getting a performance laptop is cooling it.
Right.
So we've got a brand new cooling solution on here that uses a vapor chamber to conduct the heat out to two large fans. We're also using a new compound, which is a combination of liquid metal and a metallic paste to do that connection from the chips to the cooling solution to give us actually absolutely the best thermal connectivity we can get out of here.
And now, you guys have which actually check out later, you guys have a breakout of the laptop that we can
we got a breakdown. You can actually take a look at the individual parts. Something else that's kind of interesting about it, how often do you clean out your laptop's fans?
My laptop's fans?
Yeah.
That's actually probably once a year, once every 6 months.
Okay, that's better than most. Yeah. Normally I hear never. Well, this has a new feature in it. Periodically, it reverses the fans.
Oh, nice.
With the idea being, let's blow out any dust that's inside that laptop and get it out of there. Because most people will never touch their fans, never change anything, never vacuum them out or anything like that.
You know, I'm a little weird and I like to tinker, so when I'm pulling stuff out, I see the fans. But yeah, you're right.
Yeah,
the regular user doesn't do that.
No,
that
they
often.
Don't. Nope.
So one of the few things that I like the most from here, let me unplug it here. From this guy is, let's go to this side, is we have here, you know, your my friend Jack, which is pretty cool, the audio jack. You have two Thunderbolt ports. That's pretty awesome. You have Type-A, you have your HDMI output, and you have a full-on RJ45, which is great. Sometimes you just see those on a lot of laptops, and then your power, then one extra Type-A port. You have ports.
Again, you said you're a gamer. You need connectivity.
Yes,
so you're plugging a mouse. You may be using a wireless mouse, but often gamers are using a wired mouse.
Yep.
So that's certainly there available.
Latency.
For networking, you might use wired or wireless. But an awful lot of gamers want that wired connectivity. So that's why the RJ45 jack is there. I mean, we really thought about this one as being the most powerful Omen gaming laptop that we've ever made. And what does it take to make it the laptop the gamer absolutely needs?
Nice. And this guy has Wi-Fi?
It has Wi-Fi 7.
Wi-Fi 7, nice. Yeah, and the good thing, like you said, from if you're doing the HyperX peripherals, one less dongle to lose, and one more port for
and
you
one
to
more
use.
Port that's free, correct.
And that is pretty cool. All right, so how about we take a closer look at the blowout of the laptop?
Yeah, sounds right, good.
Let's go. All right, Kevin, so actually when I walked into the room, I don't think I even say hi to you because I just went like right here. It's like, oh my God, because I'm a nerd, I'm a geek, and I love this. And I love that you guys have this exploded view of the laptop that we were just looking at.
Yeah, I'm a techie, and I think you are too. And being able to see the insides of the laptop is really interesting. And it's nice that you don't have to get out your screwdriver and start taking it apart. So what I really want to point out here is that thermal solution. Mm-hmm. This is the motherboard, and of course you got the CPU, you've got the space for the GPU, all of that. Here, you can see the pads that connect up to those with the thermal compound on the pads. So that thermal compound connects to the pad to conduct heat really efficiently from the chip onto the thermal solution.
Right.
So look at all the copper here. A really hefty thermal solution. Two large fans, big radiators that they're sending the air through to get the heat out of the system. And actually, I mean, if we took a look at the bottom of the machine, we've got large grids on the bottom to make sure that that airflow goes really well. Also, it flows out the back of the machine. Mm-hmm. So unlike some gaming machines where you've got your hand next to it,
right,
and you got that heat blowing right out on it on your hand on the mouse, this one, it all blows out the back.
Oh, that's
so
really
nice. It's a lot nicer. And then, of course, as I said, these fans will reverse periodically to blow out the dust.
That's pretty cool. So you were saying that, like, we're talking a bit earlier, so this is a vapor chamber, so
yeah,
it's a pretty good, a really good, actually, heat dissipation mechanism. And I love the motherboard here, and one of the things that I want to point out is, like, you have here DDR modules that you can actually upgrade if you want to.
Yes, you can upgrade the memory, you can also upgrade the SSDs if you need to. And it's got two SSD slots.
That is beautiful. And you also have these little modules, can you?
Yeah, one thing I wanted to point out. The IR sensor senses the heat internally to the machine. And we've got a new mode on this one. It's called unleashed mode. Mm-hmm. And the unleashed mode gives a user a lot more capability of doing things like overclocking and things like that. Of course, I mean, there are dangers to that. If you're doing too much overclocking or changing voltages or things like that, you can sometimes do damage to a machine.
Right.
And one of the things we've done here is we're using this sensor to make sure that if it detects a dangerous situation inside the machine, it'll soften it to make sure that you're not going to actually damage the computer. And that's pretty valuable. I mean, it's a nice machine.
Yeah,
people like to experiment, but you got a little bit of a safety net here.
Nice. That's a nice safeguard. And this guy, for example, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, that way is you can actually, that's a USB Type-A.
It's serviceable. So
yeah,
it's
exactly.
Type-A port. If something broke on it, you don't have to replace the whole motherboard. You can just replace the port.
That's really nice, because those guys, of course, they take most of the beating of plugging in, plugging out.
Yes.
Especially USB Type-A, which you have to turn around three times to get it right.
Right.
Yeah. So, no, this is great. I love it. Thank you so much, Kevin. Thanks for having us.
Yeah.
I love this product.
Happy to talk to you about it. As you can see, I'm proud of it.
I know. It's beautiful. Thank you.